Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, we bring to you the 10 most fascinating shipping container art and sculptures from around the world. Stay tuned to find out more on this interesting global adventure. Welcome back. Shipping containers are designed for shipping and storing goods. Most of them often get discarded or remain unused once they reach their destination. In order to utilize these boxes of steel, most of them have been modified and converted into homes, offices, shops, even swimming pools. In addition, artists all over the world have also used shipping containers as canvas for their art and sculpture. If this is the first time you are watching Shelter Mode videos, feel free to visit our YouTube channel for hundreds of videos on shipping container homes designs, shipping container design ideas, and comprehensive reviews of most influential shipping container homes from around the world. Remember to subscribe for our weekly videos and don't forget to click on the bell to get notified whenever we post a new video. Without further ado, here are the 10 most fascinating shipping container art and sculptures from around the world. Number 10, the trash puzzle container art. The trash puzzle, popularly called self-contained, is a three-dimensional temporary wall that is a fascinating collage of textures, colors, and repurposed objects built by Swedish artist Michael Johansson. Johansson's installations make use of discarded shipping containers in different sizes, an old car, a tractor, shipping pallets, a camper, fridges, a trash can, and other large items. The different pieces fit together in an intricate arrangement, giving the installation a look that is like a trash puzzle. Number 9, Northwest Walls, a Rock Watcher Festival. World street artist Roa is renowned for animal paintings completed for Northwest Walls as part of the Rock Watcher Festival held in Belgium every year, starring along work of other talented international artists. The colossal stacks of shipping containers have become the canvas for artistry and imagination, where each artist paints the towering, tottering boxes in colorful and richly detailed pieces of art. The public art installations remain situated at the park until the following year, when a new crop of artists will repaint the shipping container surfaces with their own aesthetic styles. Number 8, the giant IOU USA containers. IOU USA is a temporary public monument across the street from the Federal Reserve Bank of Kansas City, designed by artist John Salves. This 65-foot high structure is made up of 117 multicolored steel shipping containers stacked 7 stories high and 15 across. The shipping containers glow as at the building, spelling out in your face message "I owe you" on one side and the other side "USA". It was conceived in 2010 as a protest to the divisive national politics, where the US Congress had just reached an agreement to raise the United States debt ceiling and cut spending by $2.5 trillion over the next several years. Number 7, the shipping container arch in Japan. This container monument is the work of a Belgian architect built in 1999. His motivation was to erect a container monument as a sculpture park to jolt the perception of scale, or at least to render it more and stable. Being able to walk around and between these pieces of steel make you experience them in a refreshing relationship with each other, the park, and the wider environment. The container installations may be described as mobile monuments where both the theme and the material are universal and applicable everywhere. Number 6, the Wow Westminster. As part of the Vancouver Biennale, this installation by Brazilian artist Jose Rezende is made out of 4 precariously cantilevered shipping containers that appear to defy gravity as they balance on one end and point up to the sky. They are assembled in 2 V's to form a W, forming a dominant view along the Fraser River from the bridges above. The Wow Westminster is not only an interpretation of the economic activity of the Fraser River and the flow of goods through trains, ships, and trucks, but also about capturing the energy and the history of this transportation hub that transformed the city of New Westminster and its waterfront into a recreational arts and cultural playground. Number 5, the trade deficit. A local artist by the name Local Riche of Denver City in Colorado was inspired by the excessive amount of unused shipping containers in the city. He used 4 shipping containers to create a series of sculptures called the Trade Deficit. Parts of the containers were cut and then welded together to create an intricate art installation. The different parts of the containers are painted in red, green, gray, and blue colors prior to being welded to other parts, giving the abstract shapes a rainbow-like feel. Number 4, the Steelhenge. The Steelhenge, built by a Swiss architecture firm Bureau R, is a modern recreation of the prehistoric English stone circle, the Stonehenge, using shipping containers, hence the name Steelhenge. The installation was built in 2015 for the first edition of the Biennale for Independent Art Spaces in Geneva. Constructed using 50 blue shipping containers, the circular arrangement of Steelhenge is based on the concentric layout of the Neolithic monument Stonehenge. The steel containers are placed in a way which references the layout of the ruins of the Steelhenge and stacked to echo its height. The entire structure was built in a single day using a crane. At number 3 is the Rainbow Container Project. This amazing sculpture by an Australian artist, Marcus Canning, is located at the Beach Reserve on Canning Highway, overlooking the Swan River and the Port of Fremantle. It is made up of 9 brightly colored shipping containers constructed in the shape of an arch, which looks like a rainbow, hence the name Containable. The apex of the arch is 9 meters above the ground, measuring 19 meters long, and 66 tons of steel were used. The full spectrum of the rainbow colors are used to represent Fremantle as a colorful, diverse city and a cultural gateway for Fremantle's energetic port city. At number 2, the Container Origami. Constructed in the Dutch port city of Rotterdam, this piece of art was originally created as an entry in an art competition. Affectionately called the Container Origami, this installation is located near one of the world's busiest shopping centers in Netherlands. The artists involved first created a model using cardboard before building a miniature prototype using metal. The final design was cut, shaped, and welded in full size from a shipping container in a warehouse before being painted its distinctive red color. Finally, it was transported to its outdoor display site, where it became one of the most interesting additions to Rotterdam's impressive public outdoor collection. Not only is the sculpture an interesting piece of art, but it also highlights the versatility of shipping containers. Last but not least is two monumental arches that sit in the city of Lahore, France. This ephemeral monument is a string of multicolored shipping containers making up two monumental arches that sit between the city and the sea. This urban sculpture is made of 36 painted shipping containers, 21 containers for the big arch, and 15 containers for the small one. The monument has a maximum height of 25 meters and a maximum footprint of 30 meters. This pair of container arches were imagined and inaugurated in 2017 for the 500th anniversary celebrations of the city of Lahore. This monument has rapidly become one of the city's most iconic sites and sometimes even referred to as the Eiffel Tower of Lahore. Did you find our journey adventurous and informative enough to help you appreciate the use of shipping containers as art and sculpture around the world? In case we haven't included a container sculpture or a piece of art made from shipping containers in your locality, kindly let us know by posting in the comments below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it. Remember to subscribe. See you next week.